That's Hugh, that's right. Tell about the princess who kisses the frog.
Yes.
And it turns into a prince.
Yes.
Perhaps we should try that.
Sure.
Okay, so you give the frog a kiss.
No way!
Thank you. Not as hot as you. Hello, beautiful. There you go.
It's like hysterical.
We've got to be the other side, haven't we?
They're on the wrong side.
Well, no, this is our plan. We need practice, actually. So I'm going to hold all of that in one hand, and I'm
going to
hold it and let go of that.
Now, there's a little question for you, Barry. Do you wish to give the hand of your daughter Anna in marriage to Hugh?
With pleasure.
With pleasure. Wonderful. Thank you very much. Do you want me to take a photo?
It's a card.
Oh, it's got a scarf on. For some odd photo of the bronze scarf. If anybody here today knows any reason why the two of you should not be joined in marriage, it is now your time to declare it. No, under 5 foot. Right on cue there. I can stay in, there's no problem. If you can repeat after me, Hugh, so everyone can hear. I declare that I know of no legal reason.
That I know of no legal reason. Why I, Hugh James William Sturrock, may not be joined in marriage
to Anna Michelle Lewis.
To Anna Michelle Lewis. Anna.
I declare
that
I know of no legal reason.
Why I, Anna Michelle Lewis,
may not be joined in marriage.
May not be joined in marriage.
To Hugh James William Sturrock.
Hugh James William Sturrock.
Okay. I take you, Anna, to be my wedded wife.
Be my wedded wife.
I accept all that you are.
I accept all that you are.
And all that you will be.
And all that you will be.
And I promise.
And I promise.
I will comfort and cherish you.
That I will comfort and cherish you.
With love and affection.
With love and affection.
Friendship and respect.
Friendship and respect.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
I promise that I will love you.
I promise that I will love you.
Honor you and cherish you.
Honor you and cherish you.
From this day forward,
from this day forward,
for as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall
live. You okay, Anna?
Yeah.
I, Anna.
I, Anna.
Take you, Hugh.
Take you, Hugh.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
I accept all that you are.
I accept all that you are.
And all that you will be.
And all that you will be.
And I promise.
And I promise.
That I will comfort and cherish you.
That I will comfort and cherish you.
With love and affection.
With love and affection.
Friendship and respect.
Friendship and respect.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
I promise that I will love you.
I promise that I will love you.
Honour you and cherish you.
Honour you and cherish you.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
Thank you very much. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And faithfulness.
And faithfulness.
And as a token.
And as a token.
Of the commitment.
Of the commitment.
We have made today.
We have made today.
And then just say, I accept the ring with all my heart.
I accept the ring with all my heart.
Keep this smile. And say, and with this ring.
And with this ring.
I take you for my wife.
I take you for my wife.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I shall be.
And all that I shall be.
Chris, we got one last one, please.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And faithfulness.
Okay.
And as a token.
As a token.
Of the commitment.
Of the commitment.
We have made today.
We have made today.
I accept the ring with all my heart.
I accept the ring with all my heart.
Then with this ring.
Then with this ring.
I take you for my husband.
I take you for my husband.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I shall be.
And all that I shall be.
Now, you've given and exchanged wedding rings. You've said the declaratory and the contractual part in front of everybody here assembled today. It only remains for me to say that you are now husband and wife. And the famous words are, just wait for it a second, you may now kiss your bride.
Your fingers touch the strings of my heart and made me say again,
Maria,
Maria, I hope you dream a thousand dreams of me, of things we plan doing together.
You know what we plan to do together, don't you? Well, all right then.
And if you do, I'll dream my whole life through a thousand, a million, a billion dreams of you.
This afternoon says more than I can speak about the pair of them. It's such a personal thing. The amount of organisation and kind of love that's gone into this is really terrifying, actually. You all know and love Anna, her generosity, her enthusiasm. The mixture of amazing intelligence, sophistication, combined with the occasional lapse into touches of Thanet. Anna hates any conflict and cannot distance herself from anyone else's unhappiness. She feels it in her warm heart. You know, she just can't. She just feels things, perhaps sometimes too much. But at the same time, there's a toughness that hopefully will come out in some of the stories. The memory that would kind of, I'm trying to remember it, because it really was so strong. I went to see her at a concert in Broadstairs in a church. I arrived just before the concert, and I got in, and it wasn't a youth thought. I was expecting, how old were you then? 17? 16 or 17, and I thought it was going to be a youth orchestra. It was a full grown-up orchestra, all in their kind of tuxes, and I sat in the church. Anna wasn't there. I was really kind of, where's Anna? And the conductor came up, tapped his back, did a kind of bow, and all the audience stood up and started applauding. And walking behind me along the aisle was Anna in a full evening dress, and she was a soloist, and that was... And finally, it was lovely, and it was very old-fashioned, but I loved it. I think we should all remember that Hugh phoned me up the night before he proposed to Anna, said, "Can I, do I have your permission?" And for three camels and a donkey, I said yes.
Next up, my lovely sister, Claire. Hey everybody. I don't know quite how to top that. I don't really have sort of that many tidy anecdotes for a wedding speech. It wasn't until much later I realised how much you need your siblings, because they're the only ones who really know what your parents are like. ever the antagonist, I broke the spell of the Easter Bunny nice and early. She's had a slightly unhappy relationship with chocolate ever since. She was the perfect peacemaker and also took care of all the overachieving, reaching grade 25 in every orchestra instrument. She sang solo as a leopard, blue solo for national orchestras. And let's not forget her extensive research into the female dog whelk penis, secure her place in the annals of science. If there's one thing Anna doesn't do, it's things by halves. She is the most energetic, caring, determined, and hilarious person I know. She works hard at everything. Friendships, academia, family life, finding the perfect guy.
I think I always knew I was going to marry her. We met playing the horn in the university orchestra. But Anna was actually probably the first person I met at university. We had our first orchestra rehearsal on the first day of term, and I remember being sat in the rehearsal in the horn section. I was principal horn. I remember being sat next to Anna thinking, this girl is definitely out of my league. I still kick myself sometimes that we're together, and seeing you come into the Orangery today, I couldn't help but think that I definitely got a better deal. Anna is completely unique. I don't think I've ever met anyone with the energy and can-do attitude that Anna has. Nothing is impossible in Anna's world. Anna's world is an interesting and exclusive world. In Anna's world, time is an irrelevant, non-existent concept. The seemingly ridiculous becomes completely attainable. Chocolate flows freely through the streets. Drivers are free to pass through red lights as they wish. And the joint account is a magical land of endless opportunity. I feel genuinely very proud and excited to be marrying Anna. If there's one thing I can be certain of, it's that the life that Anna and I have ahead of us is going to be exciting. She brings things out to me that I didn't realise I had. Anger, frustration. She really adds to my personality, and I wouldn't be who I am without her. Whilst we are different on a number of levels, I think we do share a lot of similarities. We both play the French horn, Anna plays the piano. She studied zoology at Edinburgh. She loves film, music, and food. She's intelligent and incredibly good looking. I think we've got a great mix of characteristics that will see us through life together, and I'm looking forward to opening it. Will you please be upstanding and raise a toast to my gorgeous wife, to Anna.
To Anna!
So as I've been standing there listening to these speeches, I've realised if you just cut them up and then piece them all together, you've pretty much written mine. In terms of all the comments that have been made about Hugh and Anna, but it just sort of goes to show sort of how true they all are. I first met Hugh when we were both 14 on my first day at school. I was unpacking all my stuff and this tall, friendly-looking bloke walked over to me. And my initial thought was, my goodness, that teacher's got a lot of moles. It wasn't until later on that evening I realised he was actually in my ear. We've got on very well ever since. Hugh's been an absolutely fantastic friend to me throughout the years, as I know he has been to so many other people. He's got a cracking sense of humour, he's quite a sensitive soul, and his generosity and his eagerness to just help out other people as and when, you know, he'll drop everything for anyone, it's just fantastic in some of them. And it's just an absolute top bloke. I'm so proud to be standing here today. This is the man who absolutely loves education. He always has, and he clearly still does. He has 64 UCAS points, which is the highest number of UCAS points ever recorded. From an early age, his love of education is clear from his school reports. In 1994, his teacher wrote, "Hugh single-handedly made concentrating in lessons fashionable." I mean, even Hugh's own mother was slightly taken aback by this comment. When I made reference to it, having read the report, Susan said, and I quote, "The way his report's read makes me wonder how he had any friends at all." But even though he owns a key to my flat, and I know his three favourite pairs of pants have hearts, aliens and Superman patterns on, and I bet you they're hearts today. My hopes of... They are, aren't they? Yeah. Ultimately, this is a couple who don't enter into anything half-heartedly, and I genuinely have a huge amount of admiration for the commitment you give to absolutely everything you do. Be it, your careers or your family, you know, the way you guys are, and your friends. I just think it's admirable. And just look at the wedding, you know, the effort that has gone into this. It's for everyone to see all around you, but, you know, and there's been a huge involvement from everyone, but without Hugh and Anna's dedication to making it what it is, it wouldn't be how it is today. It's obviously just a fantastic occasion.
Last night I had a dream. A dream that thank you.
right. Okay, you win. I'm in love with you. Well, all right. Okay, you win. Baby, what can I do? I'll do anything you say. It's just got to be that way. Well, all right. Okay, you win. I'm in love with you. Well, all right. Okay, you win. Baby, what can I do? Anything you say, I'll do. As long as it's me and you. But the first thing in the morning,